Welcome back, folks. Before we go on, I just want to check on some sports stats, you know, keep myself sharp here on the sports, and I'll use my computer and just go in here, and I'm going to check, okay.
About that time. Double bang. My name's Dave. Welcome to Too Much Dip. It's Monday. KJ and Dylan in the building. We've got a special guest to talk hockey in a moment. Let's meet the guys. Dylan, is it heavy?
Oh, come on, man.
Does he meet it up?
Oh, that's, I'm sorry. It's inappropriate. I am very happy to be here. After a strong start. We've got playoff hockey to talk about.
Mm-hmm. Brett's our special guest.
NHL correspondent stepping in the studio, man. I'm just excited. That's all I got to say.
It's not like Doc Emmerich. We got Brett.
I'm just excited.
Which is great, too. He's very knowledgeable.
Oh, I do have a confession before we talk to KJ. Yesterday, you texted us, and you were like, hey, is anyone hopping on? Want to do like an afternoon like for dance session?
Oh, yeah.
I ignored your text because I was feeling like a little solo-y at the time. I wanted to fly solo. So I did. I hopped in for dance, and I got a dub solo. I'm sorry.
Without That's okay.
You. Yeah.
You wouldn't have got a dub with me.
I caught that dub. I know. You always hold me back. It's true. But anyway, we had fun playing last night.
Yeah.
I guess.
I got two games in than Rhodes. Took six separate times to try to get him back to sleep. But then he slept through the night.
Be like that sometimes.
I told you. When I texted the group, I said, I think it might be one of those nights, and I was right.
Just one of those nights.
What did y'all end up doing that game?
Nothing. In any.
We probably would have won if we had a fourth person helping us out, because it was 3-on-4.
I do recall.
No, y'all got second?
We were making moves. Not to put it on you, but you definitely ruined it.
Dude, I gave you all the $400 I had on my person, and I laid down.
It turns out it wasn't enough.
How long did I last? Any idea? Enough.
Not very.
I had this thought as
I was trying to get Rhodes back to sleep. It was like, dude, what if like I come out 15 minutes later and the game's like getting down to the final circle and somehow I'm still in it and they've written me off?
We would have, I think we know the deal now. Like, once you've got the stick back in your hand, you hit up and people know to go buy you back. I held on to some cash. We were ready for it.
But, yeah.
That's KJ, folks.
Aside from ditching us in Verdansk, I'm eager to hear your review of the motion picture epic that you took in over the weekend.
Yeah, I watched Creed 2, actually last night.
Okay.
I was a fan of Creed 1.
You want to hear a big fact? I haven't even seen Creed 1.
I don't care.
Well, you're missing out a little bit.
Creed 1 was
good. It's nothing that I would like say, hey, go rush and watch.
So, the Rocky movies, they're known for being over the top, specifically their fighting scenes, the boxing scenes. They're not realistic. And that's part of the allure.
You mean you can't take like 150 right crosses straight to the face?
From like the most dangerous, savage Russian dude on the planet who happens to be on all the steroids.
He's like the world record for PSI punching.
He can't just tee off on your head, 55 times
right.
in a matter of minutes.
Interrupt to ask one question before you jump off here. Were you watching this like in preparation for like Kyle's podcast or for content purposes? This was just your selection.
My mother-in-law had just got in town.
Okay, that doesn't make it any more reasonable.
I had TNT on. I think I had been watching NBA.
All right.
And it rolled right into Creed 2. And
now,
I was like,
we're getting
you know what?
It wasn't a selection. You let it happen.
So for the first 30 minutes or so, my mother-in-law and I were catching up, and then I was like, all right, I'm going to really watch this movie. And I watched it, and let me tell you, the movie is pure shit. It's just the worst.
Really?
I'm not sad that I watched it. It's just like, compared to Creed 1, I feel like they went out of their way to make it a little bit more realistic. Michael B. Jordan's great. I generally support most of the things he does. Sylvester Stallone's in it.
You know, he was in The Wire.
Right.
Michael B.
Have you started season 4 yet?
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
So, season 4 started off very slowly.
So you met Snoop.
Mm-hmm. He has.
You met Chris and Snoop.
Felicia Snoop.
Oh, yes, yes. Snoop's great.
Mm-hmm. Has she gone to the hardware store
yet? That was an incredible scene.
And that's the scene I was waiting for.
Yeah, incredible scene. But aside from that, season 4, very slow so far.
It's probably the We're speaking of course, live and in color motion television series, hit television series, The Wire here.
Mm-hmm.
I will say that's the season that definitely led to some tears.
Okay.
But enjoyed it.
You will be very, very mad. I think hopefully you are very, very angry at the end of it.
One of my favorite recurring things of the show is every time Omar just walks down the street, mm-hmm. like he went to go buy cereal just now in one of the scenes, and everyone warns, like they just shout, yep. Omar's coming, and everyone just clears out the way.
I love that theme that respect. They carry on.
That's what people do at the gym Omar. For you.
Right. Dylan's coming.
Rowdy gentleman. Passing the free weights.
RG zone.
Stop.
He's about to put up those 60s.
One of the RGs.
Oh, God.
Passing the plyos.
Day one RG. but, yeah, Creed 2, man. Okay, I was a little harsh on it. It didn't. It was just the – so he fought. You know the premise of Creed 2, right?
No.
They fight.
Creed, you know who Creed is, right? You know
son,
his
yeah, son of –
Apollo's son. Yeah. Apollo, of course, is dead.
R.I.P.
And he fights Andre Ward in the first one. And it's not Andre Ward. But in this one, now he's the champ. He fights what's his name? Drago. Drago's son.
Played, of course, by Sage Northcutt.
It's not Sage. Not Super Sage.
Oh, it's not?
Sage
he didn't get the part.
Tried to get the role. And the whole time, as Drago's son is on screen, I'm just laughing to myself, thinking, like, what if this was Super Sage? First of all, Sage isn't big enough. Sage is jacked, but not a big enough
not
dude.
Not tall enough.
Not tall yeah. enough. And just the fact that he's Sage Northcutt. He's a nice,
bubbly person of all time.
He is a golden retriever on steroids.
Yes.
Not literally on steroids that we know of, but I'm just saying. He's got a great personality. Very nice guy. He is not Drago's son at all. Anyway, Creed fights him. First one, he wins on disqualification because he's getting just manhandled. And he gets downed, and he's on one knee. And Drago's son just tees off on him illegally. Yeah,
while loses on the knee.
So he loses on disqualification. And then they fight again, and you can probably imagine how that one goes.
Does the music start right as the comeback begins?
There is the music. There's some nostalgia in that. Yeah.
So the part that Sage Super Sage Northcutt wanted is a pretty substantial role in this movie.
He's not a bit character. He is antagonist,
major,
if you will.
Major character.
Who played Drago's son in this movie? Is it not?
I think it was Mickey Rourke.
It was not Mickey Rourke. When I looked at the pictures from the movie and then saw the guy we were talking about last week about to potentially fight Canelo.
Billy Joe Saunders.
No,
Caleb Plant.
Yes. Is it him playing this actor?
No.
Okay.
But this dude is big. This dude's huge. He almost has a body that's too built to be like, oh, you would not be a boxer. But Anthony Joshua is just as ripped. But
yeah, same problem.
Anyway, I was very disappointed.
Hmm.
But whatever, man. That's really much all I got to say about that. That's okay, man. I hopped into Verdansk for a couple games after.
And you left us hanging.
Left you hanging.
Can I tell you a quick little anecdote about how my day went today? Aside from, riding the waves of some pretty hefty weather, which might come down and get us during
this
episode.
There's a gnarly storm moving in.
Seriously? I was just typing away, headset on, just doing my work, in the next room over here in the office here in the lodge. And gentleman walks in the door and comes around. He's like, hey, I think you're in my desk. Just kind of knocks on the desk and looks me in the eyes like, I think you're in my desk. I'm like, all right, man, my bad. I'll go move to the couch. So apparently you guys had an intern start today and he just punked the shit out of me
Holy
like day
shit.
One.
Holy shit. He came in hot, man.
And like, I don't like that it was you that had to go through that, but I do like that he came in with that swag, with that attitude. Like, we need an attitude.
We need some more edge in this company.
I see.
A lot of people say that about us.
Yeah, we're not edging enough.
You tried to pull like the whole new guy move on me.
I'm not talking about edging. It's a little bit different, but I'm glad that he set the tone early with you.
Hey, he let me know where I stood, in the company corporate structure. He's like, hey, you're going to have to rearrange that org chart. I know you're just a free floating circle over there, a contractor, if you will. But, I've got an email, so get the fuck out of my seat.
We're, I was like, all right, man, TBD I get it. On the email. Randy's working through the proper TBD. Channels.
In all seriousness, though, he did then go on to ask, like, hey, introduce himself. I won't dox the guy until you guys formally introduce him in another place. He followed that up with, asking if I was on one of the podcasts. And I'm like, I get it. I know without makeup on, you can't recognize me, but I was like, yeah, do too much dip with guys. And he goes, yeah, my parents love that one.
Heck yeah.
Yeah, he informed him, said his parents listened to the podcast. So
yeah.
And I think about the time that we started talking about the Dick Saloon on Circling Back. Perfect. You're going to work where again with these guys?
You realize that's your fault. That wouldn't even be a thing if you didn't think it was so absurd.
I saw some people on Reddit talking about that bit, the Dick Saloon, and some people were saying how it was might be one of the funniest of all time, and then other people started to chime in and say, well, actually, I think it's what's funny about it is that Dylan thinks it's so funny, and that's why I think it's funny.
I think that is part of it.
It's incredible. I'll take it. It's positive, constructive criticism coming from that one.
It's like a fire that, like, I don't have an analogy.
It's a
Fuck.
Fire. It's just like a
it,
fire.
It passed the shivery line. You know, yeah. It's not the Mendoza line, but if it can get Dylan to crack, then it's worthwhile.
I can't really even explain why I think it's so funny, but it really just taps into my...
Look, it's on paper not that funny, but when you're sitting around your house and you're just kind of hanging out, watching Creed 2, then and you just start talking to yourself in the voice.
For 4 days after we did that segment, I would just think about it, and I would be like, you know, doing laundry, and I would just start laughing to myself out loud.
Full disclosure, you know, just trust tree, you know, trust nest stuff here. For a good 14, maybe I did a 16-month lease, I lived less than 100 feet behind a bar called The Hidden Door.
The Hidden Door.
One of the more well-known gay bars in Dallas. Mm-hmm. And I never thought twice. It was just a bar called The Hidden Door. I was like, maybe one day I'll go have a drink. Until my father-in-law picked me up from my place for the first time to go out to lunch, you know, with my now wife. We were just dating at the time. And he sees it and he goes, hey, KJ. And it wasn't nice to meet you. I've known the guy for years. But he's like, good to see your place. Did you mean to live right behind the hidden door? And I'm like, I guess maybe. I've got a bar down the way. It wasn't until about a week later and they had an outdoor foam party.
Oh, leather, sick.
Lit.
Leather and everything outdoors.
Chaps.
Absolutely a situation. I probably should have went. I would have probably had a blast.
That's a lituation. So.
I don't know if I agree with your idea of what the Dick Saloon is or isn't. No one said what, like, if this is a gay bar or not.
I know, but that's
maybe the implication to some, but
that's the way I
be.
Imagine it in my head. And for me, I hoped. That's what makes it so funny. The Dick Saloon.
Well, it wasn't supposed to be a thing we focused on. It was just a stupid comment. Because
like the idea
Will's place
of,
was the Dixie Saloon.
The idea of like
canceled.
Like a 60-year-old cowboy, you know, with a
yeah,
gnarly
we know
mustache.
The bit.
And he's just like, yeah, well.
Come on in.
You
mean it wasn't supposed to be a segment on Too Much Dip, too? The thing's got legs. It's got balls and legs.
We didn't even. We managed to ignore it on Circling Back.
What brings you boys by here?
All I can say is I can relate, and I appreciate it. I look forward to being a patron of the Dick Saloon. You guys do great work over there.
It'll be a pop-up.
Both me and the intern's parents agree.
God, I'm so sorry to the Youngs.
Yeah, yeah. Look, we have fun. Sometimes it's a little distasteful, but, you know, it's fun
nonetheless.
What are
we doing here? You guys want to talk golf?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Yeah,
this is the first thing
you
on the rundown.
You could have said no, and we could have said, fuck it, and move right on.
Did you guys catch any of the Nell?
I kind of love the rain delay.
You watched a little by Nell?
A little bit, yeah.
The Byron.
The very wet Byron.
Dude, the wet Byron.
Nelson. The Nelson? Is that what the locals call it?
The wet. Yeah, it's controversial. Some are like the Byron, some are the Nelson. I was always a Nelson guy. To Dallasites, I think that's.
Byron Nelson. I'm trying to think because it was definitely. It's a. The vibe of the Byron Nelson is like whatever you think of the Waste Management Tour, like pure party, like an absolute scene for like ASU and Arizona kids, all that postgrads to go like rip it up. Byron Nelson has always been the same guy who's going to throw a Mavs jersey over his, you know, button down and go to a basketball game is going to go to Byron Nelson and just be absolutely blackout for 2 or 3 days. So it's a corporate pavilion. Party. It's a corporate party scene for sure.
The golf is generally secondary.
Is it in McKinney?
Now it is. Kind of a controversial thing there. So City of Dallas got involved and took it from Las Colinas, where it was for years, right in the heart of like corporate Dallas.
That was at peak Nelson. Yep. They had the pavilion, which was a total scene.
Worked there 1 year.
If you're looking for people to watch, that is the spot.
Very Dallas.
If you know what I mean.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Gotcha.
A lot of people who've been dislodged from, you know, beds, washer machines, and the like attend that event.
I see what you're saying. Yes.
But they moved it to South Dallas or Southern Dallas last two or three years to a course called Trinity
Forest. It's a Coors Crenshaw course. It's a links course. It's a fabulous place. Romo's a member there. You'll hear when the guys come in town. Oh, to play the Coors, Jim. Aikman plays out there. All the big dogs, but they moved it out there, and
there are no restaurants or nothing. There's nothing around. Getting there is not really that easy. Beautiful place in Southern Dallas, brings money south of I-30 in Dallas in a poor part of town, but. What's a links course for idiots like me?
So there's zero. There's like one tree on the course.
Okay.
Which was also a problem.
Yeah.
For them shade relocating purposes it for and shade whatnot. for the. But yeah, links style course is it's not target golf. You're hitting shots into greens and rolling it up. The wind is supposed to be a big player.
Okay.
And one like the first year the wind didn't blow, so they just went out there and just ate the course up. I don't know. I was excited when they moved it there because it was different. Apparently, the pros didn't like it. You know, links course is what you generally play an open championship on. Mm-hmm. I think St. Andrews.
I think I played Earl Campbell's.
Very wide open, but very undulated bunkers, big long, all that stuff. What?
Nothing. I'm just happy for anybody who caught my Earl Campbell's hot links course joke. But yeah, so it's in McKinney now. As Dylan very briefly stated. And
yeah, sorry.
Off the top.
You didn't need the lesson
TPC
on South
Craig
Dallas.
Ranch. I was confused about what a links course is, so I was concerned. Apparently the scene is back.
Let's go.
People were out.
People were out. McKinney's not close to where KJ and I are from. It is, like, honestly the opposite of close. It's further than Frisco. It's north. It's north, northeast.
It would be putting a tournament on the northern side of Georgetown.
Ooh.
Basically.
That's a haul.
Like and just as hard to get up there, like during rush hour, basically. It would take you an hour plus to get there from where, you know, Duncanville, DeSoto, maybe 40 minutes from Central Dallas.
Gotcha,
but
gotcha.
That's where the burbs are. Klein probably could have got there in 25 minutes. So,
it's a growing part of the area.
What happened on Sunday? Because going into Sunday, Spieth is back, all of this. Spieth's
major
continuous track.
Stopping.
So, Spieth never made a move. I think he shot 71 yesterday. He was like three or four back. He made some noise. He drained some long putts.
Guys were going hella low, just mad low.
We had dudes out there with license plates with the
I was trying to find it on the fly, but I can't find it.
Dude, I mean, he's the fan favorite there. He's the Dallas kid. He's the Texas kid. And everybody loves him. So people were excited. People were boozed up and wanted to yell at Jordan.
Still playing well.
Oh,
still
yeah.
Still playing well.
Honestly, like, if you want to see him perform at the PGA Championship this week, you probably don't want him to win the Nelson
because
I don't know what those numbers look like, but you don't see a ton of guys go win back-to-back and then on the second half win that major, right? But
he's getting close, man.
Well, he won. He won in San Antonio this year.
I know, but, I mean, close to being Spieth of the, you know, 6-7 years ago Spieth.
Okay.
I mean, he has the boots to prove it if you don't believe him.
That's true. He does have the boots. Fur included.
That's true.
But yeah, so your winner, K.H. Lee, South Korea's own winner, won it 25 under. They tore the course up the first day. I think it was live clean in place in the fairway. The wind was not blowing. What?
I'm just listening.
The players, they went low.
Gotcha.
And you know, you had Sam Burns who won his first tournament a few weeks back in his last start. He didn't play well. He's the Shreveport guy. I think he was an LSU Tiger. LSU? He's got LSU vibes if he's not. He's a Callaway guy. He has the inexplicably large hat that looks like it's covering his earlobe or the top of his ear, but it's not.
He's just got some weird lobes.
Something's weird.
Yeah. Mm.
Low lobe.
Yeah.
Did you see he was there Lisa to congratulate K.H. Lee at the end of his round?
K.J. Choi.
The one and only.
Oh, K.J. Choi.
Is made
the original K.J.
Dry cleaning pickup. Way more entertaining throughout my life. I didn't know he lived in Dallas, which may lend to why this happened. My office is in the Valley Ranch, Las Colinas area when I had an office in person. Took dry cleaning to the same place all the time. Oh, just like KJ Choi. I'm not doing an accent there. Disclaimer.
To be clear.
Disclaimer. But they would always say that. And I'm like, okay,
Did you know who KJ Choi was?
Yeah, but I mean, you could have also eventually like got around to saying like Kevin Johnson, minus the creepiness. Another KJ out there, but it's probably because KJ Choi lived locally too. So shout
yeah,
out
I had completely forgotten that he was
Korean golf superstars
who lived in Dallas. But I mean, all in all, it looked like a success. Yesterday it sucked because they had the rain delay and they got a ton of rain. I think like 3 or 4 inches.
How did they finish that?
I don't know.
I guess that's the difference again. We're explaining how far away from my house it is. So me being like, it rained like hell at my house has no impact on what happened an hour north of me. Randy, any luck at all on the fly with what I sent you?
There it is.
This is the scene from Saturday.
Oh, no.
Dude, why is his buddy absolutely jacked? Look at the arms on that dude.
Dude, that guy is testosterone replacement therapy all over him, man.
Goodness
gracious. He wants you to look at any and everything besides his lack of a chin. He's doing everything he can to hide the lack of proportion on his head.
I tweeted this video. I know No Laying Up posted this still.
Mm-hmm.
This is Dallas, a microcosm of Dallas. You've got the guy who might be doing cocaine. I don't think he is. I think it's just a bad timing to pause a photo, but it does look like he is adjusting his nose, Dylan.
The guy in the back drinking what I assume is a Mick Ultra with croquis on.
Shout out to croquis.
And
frog skin Oakleys.
Yeah, I was gonna say Costas, but I don't think those are Costas.
Yeah, those look like gas station glasses, or they're like Oakleys, because you don't get those blue lenses on real glasses. And then the guy who paid for it all, just sitting quietly down up front.
The guy funding everything.
Exactly.
Yeah.
What's crazy about this, aside from the fact that the guy's got a really ridiculous vanity license plate that I'd like to think through the thought of, I might as well just take this off, put it on a chain, and wear it into the festival. Like,
is it on a chain?
It's on like a lanyard.
Oh, okay.
I think he used like his access pass
That's
lanyard.
Awesome.
Did Flavor Flav ever have this on his?
This is so much better. I love it.
Is that multiple people in the replies every time this picture's popped up? Like, people in the area know this guy and they're like, oh, he drives a, you know, I'm not going to dox him here, but drives a black SUV of sorts and drives like an asshole, blah, blah, blah. I've seen him around town all the time. So I'm like, if you're going to run around with a vanity plate like that, especially with someone's name on it.
Wait, do we think that's a real plate?
1,000%.
Why do you think that?
Other people in the replies have like shown pictures of the guy
I've seen
driving
that video.
Town.
Oh, really?
So if you're going to drive around with some other guy's name?
Off the whip and...
Yes.
Oh, okay. It's not making sense.
So he's
got to
like put it on before he gets back in this car?
I thought this was like a gift shop license plate,
you
know?
Oh, man. I guess.
He got this
at
the airport.
Are you allowed to get another person's name as a vanity? There's an approval process, isn't there?
I don't know how, but apparently he got it done. When I was trying to find this photo, somebody had an Ohio plate with Spieth on it, which is probably just random. But still, if you're going to have somebody else's name on your vanity plate, maybe don't drive like an asshole and give them a bad rep, because you know 99% of the people have seen this car and are like, that guy.
He's just a double agent trying to tank Spieth.
You know, Jordan Spieth.
Yeah. Earning potential.
What a weirdo.
Anyhow.
That's funny.
Should we bring our hockey expert in here?
Well, hold on. Let's get to the PGA Championship.
Sorry, yes.
Real quick. Starts Thursday at Kiawah Island Ocean Course. Dylan, it's a Pete Dye course.
Yes. And if you remember,
the now canceled Chris Harrison.
We have a connection at this.
Will not play Pete Dye course.
We have a connection at this golf course.
Do we?
Mm-hmm.
We do. I told you about it. We've been not like invited, but like if you guys come, we will take care of you situation.
That's all we have to do?
Stop, dude. Don't make it dirty.
No, I'm not. I'm just saying you just have to show up there.
I apologize, Mr. and Mrs. Intern.
We will be better. Show up somewhere.
I did not know about this. You know it's widely regarded as one of the most difficult courses in the world.
I did not
know
that.
Or at least in the country.
So I would go low, you're saying? No, I didn't know that.
You probably wouldn't even. You'd make some shit up about your back. You'd ride along in the cart.
That's
drinking Vizzy hard seltzers.
Yes.
It actually sounds kind of tight.
Super tight.
What's more likely in those scenarios when you know a course is difficult that you play and then you're like, all right, screw it, this is dumb, hard, and give up? Or that you're like, yeah, I'm just not going to waste my time trying.
Yeah, it's like
For
me, it's like this is all about having fun. And I'm not expecting to play well, so I get to let loose and just let it rip a little bit.
That's when you have to be prepared to like, all right, let's play Kartners. Let's scramble. Let's do something. Let's play. We got a wolf at least.
I might not even fill out the scorecard, honestly. Just have fun.
Right. Man. Makes sense.
I would, but I'm built different.
You are, yeah. You're very
Rory definite. McIlroy is your favorite, 11-1. JT, 14-1, Dylan. John Rahm, also 14-1. One Jordan Spieth, aforementioned, 16-1.
Let's go.
Bryson DeChambeau, 16-1.
Okay. Who's DJ?
DJ's 18-1. DJ has not been playing well, and he hasn't played. Yep. He withdrew from the Nelson. Victor Hovland, 25-1, which
That's your dog, man.
You could talk me into that. Yeah, I don't really know. I kind of think I like this is going to go out of going out on a limb. JT or Rory?
Give me Schwartzel.
It's a long course. You like Charles Schwartzel?
Schwartzel?
Hey, man, he's got the unstable putter, but he's been playing well. He was in the mix yesterday for a time.
Well, I'll go with that Dallas guy's favorite golfer. I'll go with Spieth on this one.
You don't want to go with Zalatoris?
No.
Also Dallas.
He's not ready.
Did he make any noise at all?
He's not ready.
Byron?
No, he was never. I think he made the cut, but he didn't sniff the lead or anything.
How do you – local guy, too. Come on.
Major L.
We made the mistake of telling Brett that he was going to be in charge of the NHL segment, and he went off on about 150 bullet points that he's been filling it out since we told him, which was about 30 minutes ago. So you want to get him in here?
And for like the first five, I thought KJ was just – going in on the NHL on this doc, and it turns out I just texted him.
Okay.
There he is.
Yeah, there he comes.
There he is. Guys, there's give a round guy. Of applause. We've got a big game Brett Merriman, folks.
Wow. There he is.
Hey, man.
Hey,
we're doing the gas station.
Do you have carpal tunnel from filling out this rundown?
Why? Is there too much on it, Dylan?
It's girthy.
Well, it's better to –
No, I'm ready. Let's talk hockey, man.
Better to
let's
come prepared, puck. You know?
Talk hey, puck. Who's your PGA pick?
Why is Rory getting so much love?
Dude, that's what I'm saying, dog.
He was putting up like 80s
flame emoji.
He didn't win majors anymore. We know that about him.
Dude.
I'm just saying.
What's Jordan at?
Is Jordan 18-1-ish.
He's 16. Top five. Yeah, 16
those are
to
good
one.
Odds. Those are good. I'll tell you, give me Jordan. He looked good this weekend.
Same dog, until same. He didn't.
I don't know if it's long enough, Jim. We'll see.
Where is it, Kiwa? Weirdly, a lot of elevation change at Kiwa, right?
Oh.
It's the ocean.
You know,
course.
It's on the coast. You know,
so there shouldn't be, but there is.
Dylan said we have a connection there, and we can go play, but all we have to do is come. Is what you
it's
said?
Not. It's not exactly what I said.
Gonna come.
Said
gonna
pop. If we arrive, they
I'm
will.
Kinda, they I'm trying to go.
Take care of us in a way.
Ooh, stormy out there, Dave. We got a line coming in big time. I've been monitoring.
Oh, yeah, baby, it's
that,
here.
I'm hoping that hail.
Oh, hail no.
Nice.
Sorry.
You want to talk playoff hockey?
That's the worst thing that's been said throughout the entire podcast.
It is ominous out there.
It's dark, man.
Are you trying to mute his microphone?
What do you do? Don't mute me. What are you doing?
No, mine was muted.
You just muted yourself.
How long was my mic muted?
Oh, shit.
Don't tell me that. You can call TV timeout and check.
Randy, can you check on the fly if his mic, he says no.
Dude, wait, there's no way.
Was it really red?
We definitely should check. I didn't see it red. So mark
I think
this,
we should.
I think it's because I bumped it.
We should continue as if it wasn't muted.
Okay.
And then we'll just figure something
out. I think
it's
because I bumped it with my little bottle.
Okay.
You were doing bumps?
Brett, save this podcast.
NHL playoffs. They started this weekend, guys. They say that they say playoff hockey is up there with the best spectacles in sports, Dylan. Have you heard
that? I didn't realize that playoff hockey started until yesterday, which I know it's embarrassing since I'm a co-host of a sports podcast.
Also
but,
a fan of the Vegas Golden Knights.
Also, who dropped game one, of course.
Correct,
in
the
OT.
Hands of Joel Eriksson Ek.
Right, but we'll be back. I'm not worried.
Your boy Marc-Andre played a hell of a goalie right now. They're on fire. That's going to be a good series.
Yeah, he made a ridiculous save last night.
A couple of them. Anyway, this is the last playoffs on NBC.
Okay.
For the foreseeable
we'll
future.
Talk about that, yeah.
It's going to, just real quick, it's going to basically, after this year, follow the same as the NBA does with TNT and ESPN kind of flip-flop in series. Each of them gets a conference final, and then the Stanley Cup final will flip-flop after this year on each of those networks. ESPN gets 4, TNT gets 3. They're saying Wayne Gretzky... You know him, Dylan.
The great one.
The great one is being courted by both of the networks to come be an analyst for them, which would be interesting.
Interesting.
Because he right now kind of does like consulting work for the Oilers.
I assume he just played golf.
He does that too. He doesn't do much work.
Okay.
But they're saying that it's like a Peyton Manning situation where he's very comfortable in what he's doing, and it's going to take some big bucks.
Some real coin, huh?
Some real coin to get him out of
maybe some Doge.
Correct. I'd like to announce I'm withdrawing my name from consideration for this role.
No? You don't – Chuck is going to be involved.
I just think I'm not fit for Hockey Night in Canada because people get the acronym confused with had something in charge, and so okay. I'm just going to go a different direction with my
career. How long have you been sitting on that?
It's always been an acronym.
Wow.
I don't know why they use it for hockey. Anyhow, let's move on.
Sheesh.
So Wayne Gretzky's been involved, Steve Levy and Sean McDonough.
Rumored I like Sean McDonough.
There's rumor to get the top spot at ESPN. Kenny Albert and Eddie Olczyk.
It's Kenny Albert.
They grabbed TNT.
My dad is Marv.
He doesn't sound anything
or
like
Marv
that.
Or Marv later.
Oh, no. So anyway, I don't know if you guys watched, but Tampa and Florida last night.
He is.
He's a more of Marv
later. Do we know about that?
Is yes. Like, oh, yes. Okay. Right. More in sports party.
Oh, yeah.
Is he a fan of the Wings at the Atlanta spot?
Yeah. Nice. Yeah. A little freakier than that.
Okay. Tampa and Florida played last night, the Battle of Florida Men. It was the best hockey game I've ever watched.
Dude, what's up with the Rats, man?
Can we quick pop quiz the room? Where do the Florida Panthers play?
Are you asking me or do you want to answer?
I think you know.
My guess is Orlando.
Okay. The jungle, baby! Thanks, Fozzie Bear. I, like an idiot for this whole time, was like, well, they play in Tampa. And then, obviously, they don't play in Tampa. Tampa plays in Tampa.
The Tampa Bay Lightning play in Tampa.
I'm still shocked to realize they also do not play necessarily in Miami.
No.
Like, they're basically in Boca, like in Sunrise, right?
Yeah, Sunrise, that's Florida, sick. Baby.
I thought they were
the
in
fever.
Baghdad, Florida.
That's sick.
They like to show the flyovers of Miami, though, as if they play right downtown. They don't.
Happens to the Cowboys and Rangers.
So in 1996, yes. Dylan, the last series that the Florida Panthers won, coincidentally, in the locker room before a game, their captain, Scott Mellenby, you know him, famous Florida
Scotty,
Panther.
Scotty, right?
There was a rat in the locker room, and he took his coho out and blasted it against the wall.
His what?
His coho, a stick, an old stick.
Oh.
And he ripped it against the wall.
Like he did a slapper?
Yeah. And he popped some rat. Anyway, went on to score two goals that game.
Did he survive the rat?
Unclear. I don't think so.
You got to think the rat was toast, man.
Could you take a rat in a fight?
Yes.
There's 7% of men who don't think they could. 6% of women.
How sad is that?
Or maybe it's the other way. It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
There's still people who don't think they could take a rat.
Anyway, since that game, they throw plastic rats on the ice.
They're fake rats? I wanted real rats on the ice.
That's a little gross and unhealthy. Yeah, have you ever heard of the plague?
They throw squid and octopus. What
in
do they
Detroit,
throw?
Yeah.
Yeah, see?
Those are water animals.
Okay, has a squid ever killed like a third of the population globally?
It's a real ass animal and they're throwing it on the ice.
A big ass squid would do that.
Is it octopus or squid?
I think it's octopus.
Calamari.
You're a squid, man.
Why did you go there? We're doing a
You're
segment.
You're a squid, dude.
It's a calamari.
No, I'm not. Yeah, calamari is good. You see the new Sammy's?
No, I don't.
Very expensive calamari.
I don't know why I'm doing this.
Anyway, Sam Bennett, he ran. The physicality last night was unbelievable. Sam Bennett ran a guy at the boards. Questionable call. He got a one-game suspension, unfortunately.
Wow. Didn't.
Let him play.
Already?
They were.
Yeah, I know.
After every whistle last night, there was scrums.
I was watching this during commercial breaks of Creed 2.
I'm glad you said it was 9,000 fans in the arena because going back and watching the 10-15-minute recap, which shout-out to Sportsnet on YouTube. Yeah. They do a great job with putting things together there.
Canadian up there.
They enjoy their product, but what I'm getting at here is the sound in the arena was electric.
Oh yeah,
electric.
Speaking of sounds in the arena, Dave, can you are you plugged in here?
Yeah.
Did you play that clipped
the sweetest sound?
Okay, the sound in hockey.
Let's hear it.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Inside 4 minutes to play. Carter drops for Kapanen. He shoots. He scores.
Yeah, that is.
I mean,
I like that post.
Piping in, crowd goes nuts. Come on.
Yeah, that was pretty sweet, man. The best sound. Best sound.
Not,
okay.
Not sweet enough for Dylan.
No, it was tight, dude.
This guy's like, have you ever heard a ball hit a leather glove at 98 miles an hour?
No, it's the crack of a bat, a wooden bat. I mean, that's
it's the sweetest bitch you'll ever meet.
That's a god tier sports sound.
I don't know if it's better than
it is.
Have you ever heard CTE occur in person, like with helmets and shoulder pads and just that crunch?
Unfortunately, yeah, I have.
Actually, on that note, the first time I watched a Broncos game from the sideline, it is alarming how violent it sounds.
Dude, we get it. You've been on the sideline for football games. Like, that's tight.
Dude, you'd like do the Texas game on the sideline or something with McConaughey?
Nah, man.
Courtside tickets guy for the playoffs is over here talking shit.
You square toed on the court.
You can hear a conversation out there.
He wore his Jordans so he could get the squeaky sounds in, too.
Ooh, I love the squeak. That's squeak. The sweetest sound in sports.
No, it ain't.
Ask and one commercials.
Ooh.
The Canadian teams.
The professor.
KJ.
Who are your favorite and one mixtape guys? Hot sauce, dude.
R.I.P. Escalade.
Escalade's dead?
Yeah, man.
Oh, that's too bad.
Oh, yeah.
Escalade.
Well, Brett just brought up a point that I was kind of bitching about earlier. We talked about it earlier in the season that they put all the teams in four pods. Like you have Western, Southern, Eastern, and Canada.
They're
correct?
All sponsored as well.
And sponsored. Which, hey, get
which
that bag.
They needed it this year.
Are they launching their own network?
No, just Major Bag Alert, Wendy's Northern Canada division of hockey.
Scotiabank North.
I thought they were all just getting pods off.
Okay, there you go. Jewel nice. Pods. Back on track here.
Sorry.
This rain is fucking us up today. I was asking the question, like, would we have the same playoff teams, like, had they played a normal schedule where you have more teams playing, you know, the rest of the league? Here, you're only playing, like, 10, you know, 8 teams in the pod over and over and over and over, mm-hmm. and then throughout the first two rounds of the playoffs. Like, I didn't realize they're carrying the playoffs either. So, anyways, that's my bitch session.
Yeah, it's unfortunate. They'll get back to the old stuff next year, though. With Seattle involved too.
How about that?
The Kraken.
They played the Crack House.
We're not doing Crack House, Brad.
Can't wait for the Maple Leafs and Canadiens to play first time since 1979. That would be like what are the biggest football NFL rivalry playing in a playoff game for the first time in like Cowboys 49ers maybe? That they are so diehard over this.
How
thing.
Does that happen?
They've just like. At some point in the NHL playoffs, they change from the 1-8 just plays like 1/8 or 2/7, whatever. They change that to a divisional system where you play like, I'm trying to get this right. You play the team. It was not basically possible for a while, unfortunately.
Impossible.
He's doing in Spanish over here. Do you know there that word? Español.
It's funny because I said it in a different language.
Right. Anyway, excited for that. That's going to be a Canadian like holiday, pretty much. Tonight, we have Colorado-St. Louis for the first time. That's going to be a fun one.
I hate both of these programs.
Yeah,
I hate St. Louis more.
Programs.
I think the St. Louis club is a
franchise.
I think I hate them a little bit more.
Well, it's a good thing because they're going to get absolutely mollywopped in this one. This is a boat.
Should be Colorado's year, right?
Let me remind you of what was said a mere 6 months ago. That a certain team from the northern part of Texas was going to get absolutely mollywhopped by a team out of Denver. And I tend to recall McKinnon was at home very early in October. September, whenever that was.
The big rig, Mr. Oleksiak, had something
the
to say.
The original big rig.
Yes. Go Huskies. Anyway, the Avs are humming right now, though. President's Trophy win. McKinnon in the playoffs, as you guys are well aware, he's a beast. He's a different animal than the
Who's
going to
win the Calder?
They won 5 in a row, I believe, the Avs.
Unfortunately, not your boy Robertson.
I don't think so.
It's going to be Kirill Kaprizov up there. Yeah. Minnesota.
Yeah.
But he put in a good effort.
Is that northern
Kaprizov.
Bias?
Maybe not Italian.
Russian?
Probably not.
I was thinking like Caprizi salad.
Right.
Tell us about your favorite salad story.
Have you ever had a sad salad before?
A sad salad.
It's dope. It's just spinach and cherry tomatoes.
It's a chub with no watermelon.
Okay.
Dude, the chub salad is no
blueberries
joke.
Instead. It's just sad and blue.
Yeah, it gets you horned, doesn't it?
It's the Leanne Rhymes.
Oh, there it is. Anyway, next series up, Nashville, Carolina. Nobody cares about this series. The Preds are gonna get smoked. The only thing here, expect a lot of like Broadway flyover shots. That's about it.
Well, we get as much golden social media content out of the Canes as we did last year.
Who knows? The Canes are a wild card in this situation. Their coach is kind of fed up with not getting a contract extension. So it's a whole big thing. I think they're having less fun here. Yeah.
Rooting for other teams last year. Their social media team
was fun to do bits until you lose. And then it's like, okay, yeah.
Fair.
Let's drop the bits. Let's get some wins. Bruins Caps, always a fun series. Who knows what's going to go on in goal? They have Dylan, this is interesting. You, Craig Anderson in goal for the Caps, turns 40 in a couple days.
Dude.
I don't know why
you can do whatever you want.
I don't know why you're directing that at me.
Anything's
possible.
I'm just
saying, you can still be an NHL playoff goaltender for like a couple more years.
I'm in my mid-30s. Not a big deal.
You ever seen The Rookie?
I was in The Rookie. Yeah. So, yeah.
True, he was in The Rookie.
So Craig Anderson, he's getting the go again tonight, pushing 40. One of their goalies has COVID. The other goalie popped a groin pretty good the other night.
Ooh, we've been there.
Anyway, here's my you want my big dip, big scoop of the week?
Okay.
Ooh. Oh,
man.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Buffalo Sabres land, Dylan.
Oh, here we go.
Donny Granato. I think he's staying on. I think he's staying on. According to sources.
Is that your big dip of the week?
That's my big dip of the week.
Is that your stud? Okay.
This is
Coach.
No, not the soccer coach. He's the guy that took over midway through. Kind of a Rick Bonus situation, actually. Dallasites?
If by Rick Bonus you mean he came in and replaced the guy who got fired the day after a team party because the former coach got too drunk and
we don't know that.
We allegedly don't know that. Astrid.
Yeah.
Never really said.
Similar to that. The our coach didn't do that stuff. He was just kind of an idiot, but he wasn't an idiot. He tried to change the game. He tried to get really, really creative with the methods. Didn't work out. So Donny Granato took over, and looks like they're gonna interview a couple guys, but he's the front runner.
So if you are not a hockey fan and did not have prior plans to watch any hockey series,
yes.
What series or what team should you tune into?
The Tampa Bay-Florida series that's going on currently is probably – that was the most fun I've ever had watching a hockey game.
Okay. That's the one Pete was talking a lot about last night?
Exactly. Okay.
That was popping.
Absolutely a blast. That made me fall in love with hockey again, and I don't root for either of the teams.
There seemed to be just as many goals being scored in the Rangers and Penguins.
Islanders-Penguins.
Oh,
New York.
I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm sorry. Islanders. You're right. Islanders-Penguins game. What made that one more exciting than the other?
The speed and physicality. Dudes were getting popped, and every moment of the game, they're like looking, trying to hit people. And after every whistle, somebody was on the ground getting face washed.
Final question.
Yeah.
Are we doing the Ing this year?
What is the Ing?
Ning.
Tampa Bay Ing.
I believe it's Ning. Yeah.
Did you get in a fight with somebody over that?
I think it's just a J-bone.
Is it? Well, I'm just asking if we're back. We're back.
Unclear on the Ning.
Okay. The Golden Knights will be taking game two tomorrow.
We'll see. Course. Minnesota plays well. They get the Calder Trophy winner.
No, I'm not worried about Minnesota.
Minnesota plays Prince Wild in their stadium. I like that.
Sneaky.
That
keep an eye on the Maple Leafs. Canadians, too. It's going to be a blast. Canada's going to be up in arms over that one.
Excellent. Thank you, Brett.
Excited. Any picks? Do you guys have a Stanley Cup winner?
I mean, you got to think the Golden Knights.
Sure. Dylan's got
I'm rocking with the Panthers.
Josh, they're rocking with you.
Okay. Because they're rocking with me.
They made a great intro video 20 years ago. Might not play anymore.
Why? Yeah, I went back and watched it. Yeah, it's problematic in some
like
ways.
Like hockey players get all the girls type of content.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm going to make my nights this more interesting. Give me the Blues.
St. Louis Blues.
I hate that pick.
At least to win the first round.
I hate that pick, and I hate you because of that pick.
You know, I hate the Blues too, but if the Blues keep winning some games here, win some games this first round, it's going to make Verdansk all the more interesting.
Because we know
an Avs fan who would be very pissed off to drop in after a loss.
I'll take the Leafs. I'll take the Leafs. Leaving a couple good teams out there, though, with the Lightning. And
more like the Maple Laughs.
Ha-ha. That'll do it for playoff hockey.
Yep.
See you next week.
Well done.
Wow, that's our guy right there. That's our fellow.
What a guy.
Brett, thank you.
That was a lot.
Yeah, he had to deal with Dylan.
You powered right through it, man.
Dylan's it shut out there. My brain down.
Oh, I'm sorry. It starts pouring down rain right behind me. I'm not supposed to take notice of it.
We're getting utterly pissed on.
I mean, it is absolutely pissing.
But outside. What it is also good for, if we were able to tune in to it audibly, probably rest and relax a little bit to it. Take a little moment of zen.
Your boy loves a good rain.
I think we're talking headspace.
Yeah, man. Wow, I don't know what accent that was, Paul.
What a seg.
What did I say?
You sound like the lead singer of the Wings. Or of Wings.
This dude does segues.
Hey.
Paul McCartney.
Headspace.
Oh, yeah.
Headspace is your daily dose of mindfulness in the form of guided meditations in an easy-to-use app, Dylan. People know this about you. You've been using this before they were a sponsor.
I use it before it became a sponsor because I love it. I'm very much a believer in Headspace. And for a beginner, well, it was a beginner, it just walks you through the process, shows you how simple it is. Pretty amazing.
It's one of the only meditation apps advancing the field of mindfulness and meditation through clinically validated research. So whatever the situation, Headspace really can help you feel better. If you're overwhelmed, Headspace has a 3-minute SOS meditation for you. They're great. They've got some to help you get back to sleep. That'll wind you down at the end of the night. Me, I'm a and KJ too. And you've got a kid yourself. We all got kids. Kids are stressful. You know, they wake you up. It's hard to get back to sleep and whatnot. They've got something for you. Their approach to mindfulness can reduce stress, improve sleep, boost focus, and increase your overall sense of well-being. We're big fans. They've got over 60 million downloads. Did you know that?
It's more than
that's
we
so
have.
Many DLs. Can make it easy for you to build a life-changing meditation practice with mindfulness that works for you on your schedule anytime, anywhere. You deserve to feel happier. And the meditation is made simple. Go to headspace.com/bang. That's headspace.com/bang. For a free one-month trial with access to their full library of meditations for every situation, this is the best deal offered right now. Head to headspace.com/bang. I like how the what?
I'm checking the time so I can do the timestamp.
Oh, okay. I like how the promo or like for the mindfulness app is bang. just a little juxtaposition.
Not there. Very zen, is it?
Bang is not as zen. No.
No.
Guys, it's basketball time. It's playoff time.
It's basketball season.
I don't know the whole song.
It's basketball season. Like season spelled the traditional way and then S-Z-N.
Might I interest you in a couple basketball quick hits before we talk playoffs?
Let's hear it.
Aaron. It's not Aaron Rodgers.
Aaron Andrews.
Alex Rodriguez. Oh. Ever heard of him? I don't know why I was going to say Aaron.
A-Rod.
Aaron Rod, I don't know what I was saying. A-Rod, the other A-Rod, went through a recent breakup.
Most high profile.
Guys, you know, high profile breakup, you know, split from Jennifer Lopez. Some people have heard about it. Affleck Week, if you hear the other podcast, Brunch, all here on the Wash Media Network, check them out. It's Affleck Week. They talked a little bit about A-Rod and Affleck splitting up. Or, I'm sorry, A-Rod and Jennifer Lopez splitting up. She got it. She got Affleck. A-Rod's like, you know what? I'm going to go drop $1.5 billion with my boy Mark Lore, and go buy the Timberwolves.
Plus Mark.
Me and Mark. $1.5 billion. Bought it from Glenn Taylor, who bought the team for $95 million previously. So he made a little money off of Kevin Garnett.
Hey, you know how the J-Lo, Ben Affleck connection, they were called Bennifer for a while?
Okay.
Remember that?
All right.
So when The Ben Wallace Hall of Fame tweet.
Oh, we're getting there. Okay.
The lady that responded to him, her name is Jennifer. Mm-hmm. And someone called him the original Bennifer.
Most people don't know what you're even referring to.
We'll get to it.
They're going to think back to what I just said, and they're like, oh, that's actually pretty funny, but I don't get it.
Did you think this was going the direction I did, and I thought we were going to get the debut of Billen?
No. Oh, stop it. Stop it.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man. Okay, sorry.
Other NBA note. Well, it's not necessarily NBA, but the NBA has had a big push to have basketball have a bigger presence in Africa. Got a ton of African basketball stars. Serge Ibaka, Hakeem Olajuwon, Luol Deng, Bol Bol. List goes on and on. Gorgie Deng. How about we throw him in there, too? Giannis, originally.
Gianna Jopp, former Maverick.
Gianna Jopp. Gianna. I can't say his first
John
name.
John Job.
It's like sounds like designer, but I can't say it.
It's hard to say.
But anyhow, they're trying to increase their presence in Africa. They started with the Basketball African League this week. J. Cole, who released an album last week, made his professional debut.
Has anybody jumped into the J. Cole album? Because it is fucking nuts.
Very happy.
Is it good?
Yeah.
Yes.
Good nuts?
It's good. And I'm not like a J. Cole guy.
I am.
I enjoy some of his songs, but I don't ever like throw on J. Cole.
I've never given him much of a chance. I think I will now.
I enjoy
it. From the gate, it's very hot.
He gets a lot of hate from people.
He does, but he is back in good graces.
Mostly Shido. Shido hates J. Cole.
He really does.
Because
when
I'm looking for a resource on all of my top rappers,
he's a big
I'm going
Wayne
to
guy.
The Lax guy. Anyhow, no offense.
Damn, shots fired.
Damn, dude.
My social media clout cannot handle any clapback from Shido, so know that I support the
he's
cause.
He's doing a triathlon this week, man. He needs your thoughts and prayers.
Anyhow, J. Cole at 36 played in this game, so still hope.
I knew he was big into the NBA. He's mm-hmm. boys with
DSJ.
DSJ. Former Mavericks first-round pick, Dennis Smith
Jr. He's got a hot
Jr.
little J, for sure.
Okay.
Seen it?
I mean, yeah.
Have you seen it?
I've seen his hot little J.
Me too. It's good.
Dude, his first point. So like they that was making
it was pretty bad.
It looked like a rec league point.
It looked like you were trying to have a putback goal playing pool basketball, but there was no pool. Like it was just one of those like he put all his body into. Anyways, he played. You know,
good for him. He's playing professionally in some capacity, and I'm not.
Points on the board. Anyhow, that's all that I wanted to mention as far as basketball.
You think he can throw down?
You're talking about six slam dunks?
I'm talking about can he dunk? Like, that can the dude dunk?
Putback did not give me any faith that there was any dunking.
He looks thick.
I get non-dunk vibes from him.
He does. I feel like he's put on some size in his decade.
36. It happens.
It happens.
What percentage of grown men do you think can dunk or like have been able to dunk a basketball?
Seven. Maybe it's
6%. Probably a great estimate.
I was going to say 6.5.
Yeah.
I was going to say 6.75.
So. Not a lot.
Well, fair.
It's familiar. Only other basketball note for the playoffs.
what's your deal, man?
Basketball Hall of Fame induction was this weekend. Kevin Garnett, Tim Duncan, Kobe, RIP, and
girl dad.
A couple, yes, girl dad. A couple women that David, you want to introduce the next to?
Kim Mulkey, the former Baylor. Yes. NCAA
now at LSU.
Women's, yes. Lady Bears.
Very happy to be there.
Yeah.
Judging by her first press conference.
I need a buddy comedy with her and fucking Ed Orgeron. I need so much content from them.
Oh, man, do you think there's a lot of masks getting worn in their offices?
They're done with it.
They're done.
And aside from Kim Mulkey,
Duncanville Zone, the greatest athletic alumni, potentially alumni from Duncanville High School, the great Tamika Catchings.
Alumnae, I believe, is the term there.
What did I say?
You said alumni, which is, of course, the plural form of alumnus.
Yeah, but nobody says, like, alumni.
I'd say alumnus, yeah.
That's really annoying.
Alumnae is a female. Once
it sounds offensive.
We're getting in there.
We're not your new friends.
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough.
10-time WNBA All-Pro.
WNBA so, All-Pro. Good for Tennessee her. Volunteer.
The most famous Duncanville alum.
Quintuple double?
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Filled out what? The sheet.
The only one recorded in
points,
point.
Rebounds, assists, blocks, steals. No shit?
Wow. Yeah. Wow.
That's a
in a high school game.
That's a game.
2021 class was also announced because they were backed up due to COVID. That class was actually supposed to go in last year. Paul Pierce, Chris Bosh, Chris Webber, and Detroit Pistons four-time defensive MVP for the NBA, Ben Wallace. Ooh, I liked Big Ben, even though he was 6'8", 6'9", and could not shoot to save his life, but played great defense and could block.
He shut down Shaq-ish in that one series.
Randy, are you able to pull up the link for thoughts here in the rundown? I'm sorry to hit you with that as a surprise. I should have made that more clear. But Ben Wallace we focus on only because a tweet came across the timeline, seemingly innocent.
The original Bennifer.
Yeah, that's not the tweet.
seemingly innocent, this woman wanted to chime in on the announcement that Ben Wallace was going to be inducted to the Hall of Fame, to which she replied something along the lines of, I'm happy for Ben. He and I used to have fun back in high school. Something, you know, along those lines.
Yeah, I've got it pulled up. Ben Wallace and myself had fun back in high school. Which, Dylan, grammar guy, is that the right way to word that? Ben Wallace and myself had fun back in high school.
No, I.
Yeah, ben I Wallace think he's right.
This is from PTA Jennifer.
Yeah, that's
bio says, kids are our future, proud PTA mom, true TV fan, Tesla owner, marble collector, mother to Desdemona. She/her.
Yeah, I should have caught on earlier that this was a bit account. I don't care that it is. But I realized upon further review that me wanting to rush to make the pass that ass around joke about PTA, Jennifer, was not as funny as realizing that the account had me beat. She followed it up with a couple replies to people like saying, hey, thanks for reaching out. Now show me your feet.
Yeah. Like, and some heavy implications that she had sexual relations with Ben Wallace in high school.
Unproven.
And then a couple funny responses from some other people after that too. Someone asked if Ben Wallace was quote unquote meated up. Another asking,
what does that mean? Like, he's just like a grill guy?
Yeah, like he's prepared for a big weekend of smoking the meats.
Probably.
That's just got back from Costco. I'm all meated up.
He's got the pellets ready.
Someone else asking if it was heavy. Which I don't know what that could be referring to.
Oh, man. I think I know. Yeah. Well, anyhow, importantly, the playoffs are here. Playing games tonight and Wednesday.
We got Spurs, Grizz, the 10 seed and the 9 seed, and then we've got Juicy, the Golden State Warriors, and the LA Lakers, the 8 seed and the 7 seed, respectively, in the West. This is going to be a late night because these are nights I probably won't be dropping in because I think these are like 9 o'clock, 9:30 games. But I mean, I'm all in for Lakers Warriors. That's insane. Steph's playing at an MVP level. I think LeBron said today. Or last night, Steph's his MVP.
Conveniently, right when they're matched up.
Yeah, just setting the bar. I think Landry pointed that out. Like, really, just in case they lose. Like, hey, ran into this MVP.
I think it's more of a Brian Windhorst didn't shed tears for you to come out and say this, LeBron.
You think he's like trying to get in Curry's dome a little bit?
I think that's all it is. He's just trying to gas him up. But regardless, the loser of that is not eliminated. The loser of the Warriors-Lakers would play the winner of Memphis-San Antonio. So, Dylan, if San Antonio makes it past Ja Morant and or LeBron or Steph, I think you've got to reveal your freak flag as a Spurs fan and, like, fully fly.
Do I have to actually start watching some games if that happens?
Hey. I need one Popovich fact from you every episode until the playoffs.
I was pretty surprised that they snuck into the play-in.
Yeah.
Did not know they had it.
King spit the bit at the end. So did New Orleans. So, Boston, Washington should be a good game. Indiana, Charlotte, LaMelo's exciting to watch.
Charlotte's a fun team.
Yeah. God, I hate to admit it, but he really is exciting to watch, man. That dude can ball.
Big baller brand.
No, no pun intended. That's his last name, you know.
Right.
But he can ball.
Unrelated to Mavrilo Balovic, of course.
It's very true. Western Conference, Utah is your one seed. Eastern Conference, Philly. I kind of like Philly to win it all this year, guys.
Ooh.
I'm just going out there.
Oh, man.
Mainly because they are like the worst matchup for the Mavs. And not that I think the Mavs are going to make the finals because they're not. But just because every time I've watched them, they are just clearly the better team. And I'm in awe at how big they are and how good they are, even though their point guard cannot shoot a lick. So, yeah,
one of my favorite things about that team.
They're dry Jays?
As good as Simmons is, he just absolutely cannot hit a J.
Yeah. The opposite of
which
you.
Is, right, yeah. And J. Cole as well.
The driest J, of course.
Yeah, it's not hot.
Brooklyn Nets, 2 seed out east. I don't know if you saw what looked to be like one of those, kids trying to do a viral video, like pass the ball and then dunk it into the pool.
Yeah, I did see that
video, but that highlight yesterday, the Nets are going to be incredible to watch.
That's one of the sickest highlights I've ever seen.
I watched it like 15 times in a row. It was so much fun.
I'm just excited to see like what Steve Nash looks like stressing out like for an inbound pass that's like in a critical moment of game on the sideline with all five of his all-star players like staring him in the face.
He's going to lose them a game, isn't he?
Yeah, 1,000%. I don't know who's on their bench, like if he has, Mo Cheeks or something on the bench. I don't know why I went there.
He's got D'Antoni.
Okay, yeah, so he's got some experience. Not that, that's going to help too much. No. We'll see. Kyrie D'Antoni. Was quoted as D'Antoni. Basically saying – I'm not all that focused on basketball as much as I am on all the I'll put some distance, interstitial, all that much on basketball as much as I am on the deaths in the world or, conflict in the world.
Recently, I don't know if he recently converted, but he did say that he is a practicing Muslim.
So,
and it is Ramadan.
Ramadan finished Ramadan. Friday.
So he was playing Eid through was Friday, that, but okay.
Yeah, so he took some games off. I think he only played evening games because during Ramadan, it's practicing Muslim, he would fast during the day, and then you can eat after sunset. So
He's an interesting cat.
He is a very interesting guy. I only bring it up to say, while I don't think that he should be anyone's spokesman, he certainly has given himself a platform, and he's using it for things he thinks are worthy discussions. I don't disagree with his angle on any of them, but you know, it also wouldn't hurt for him maybe to package his message in a manner that might gain more support, I would say. So that's all I would be looking for out of him. Okay. But I agree with the fights he's had.
Have you talked to him about that?
You know, we were meeting at the monthly I'm not even go back to that. Nope.
Okay.
Meet it up.
I've dug the well for Hockey Night in Canada too many times.
Got Mavs Clippers running it back.
Mavs Clippers.
How do you feel about that?
Had a generic conversation with a guy in my neighborhood about it who's a big Mavs fan.
Okay.
Kind of like
he's not a Marcus Morris guy.
He's just like, who do you want, man? You want the Nuggets or you want the Clippers? Pick your poison. And I was like, I had Randy, and I'm like, well, I don't know, man. He got the MVP. I don't want any part of Kawhi. You know, that I literally said that. And I don't, to be clear. I also don't want any part of the Nuggets, even without what's his name, Jamal Murray.
Yeah.
So Mavs won. They beat him twice last year in the playoffs, right? It was 4-2.
Mm-hmm.
Lost in 6. Didn't have KP for the latter half of the series.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just a weird – they were bullying Luka. Somebody called – didn't
this
somebody call –
bitch-ass white boy came.
Bitch-ass white boy.
Montrezl Harrell, who's no longer there.
No, he's in the other team in LA.
Yeah, yeah.
But – and then, like, you had one of the Morris brothers stepping on Luka's shoe. Just a bunch of weird – and they were playing aggressive. They're going to be watching this series. There's going to be a lot of tees thrown out. Not in like a that way, Dylan.
Unfortunately.
But it's going to be fun. I look, you want my prediction? Mavs in 4.
Wow. That's aggressive.
Okay, not really. Give me Mavs in 7.
I agree. Ooh, I think the Mavs will win. The biggest difference between last year and this year is, I mean, I don't know if he gets enough credit, but why am I just completely blanking? Mo Cheeks is the only coach I can name right now.
Dude, you're just thinking about Cheeks.
Well, what got me here was thinking about Fergie's anthem, but the himself. Anthem in Portland.
I'm trying to buy something.
Where the lady like freaked out and Mo Cheeks saved her.
Oh, the
anyways,
anthem,
yes.
Yeah.
I don't know why that's on my mind. But anyhow, back to my point.
That was a sweet moment.
Doc Rivers is not there. That's really what I feel like is missing. Not that I don't believe in Ty Lue. But I think Doc Rivers is an exceptional talent, an exceptional coach. Maybe he doesn't always get the job done with some of the talent he's had around, but he will win a lot of close series and a lot of games. So I think that's reason to believe in your Philly pick, but it's also reason that I'm not really thinking that the Clippers are going to put this together.
Despite the Mavs land just a big old turd last night in Minnesota in their last game that ended up just not really mattering,
mm-hmm.
I think it's a better team. It's a better Maverick team this year. If you can have KP for the entire series, then you're golden.
You need Maxey too.
You need Maxey. You need and J.J. Redick, I don't know if he's going to even be available. The whole thought with him was like, okay, he's going to be able to win you a game or two in the playoffs. Just he's savvy veteran, and he, you know, traditionally has shot the three well, although he hasn't been shooting it that well this year. But I don't know, man.
It'll be fun.
It's going to be stressful. I'm going to be pretty miserable, more so than usual, the next couple of weeks. So. Set the bar very low for myself.
With that said, you want to party a little bit?
You guys want to party?
Yeah.
Let's do it. It's a sports party.
Mm-hmm.
It's a segment where we party and talk about sports. Rombauer.
Yeah, I was going to get y'all. I couldn't pronounce it.
What was the name? Rombauer.
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 That's your Preakness winner.
By 3 lengths.
Medina
lengths.
Spirit third. This is probably best case for Medina and Bob Baffert, right?
Why?
If Medina Spirit, amidst the controversy,
I think you
won,
want your horse to win, though, right?
If it won, then people will be like, dude, what is going on here? Getting third, it's like, okay, it was still competitive, and like, you know, there's going to be extra scrutiny on the testing.
Or having tested negative, mm-hmm. which it did,
allegedly.
To win the race then,
allegedly.
Makes it look like.
You win without it.
Yeah.
So either way, he got third. I don't know. Like how much that impacts your money in horse racing. Like, I know in golf, like yeah, you're losing hundreds of thousands, but you're still making a ton of money when you, you know, you end up in second or third place.
Yeah. So, you know, the real money's in the stud fees, Dave.
Don't I know it.
That's where the real money is. All right. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you'd know. Because you're a stud.
Okay. Oh, thanks, man.
Yeah.
Appreciate you.
Speaking of studs, we got Tyson Fury, Anthony Ooh. Joshua announced for August in Saudi Arabia, the kingdom. Wow. Just love seeing just big marquee sporting events in Saudi Arabia.
Two big Brits just beating each other up in Saudi Arabia.
This is the fight that people have wanted for years. Mm-hmm. Finally going to get to see it.
What threw this off? Reese beating Joshua threw this off track, right? Because that's when we got Wilder Fury, right?
Very likely, yeah. That was like kind of the wrench in this. And then,
and then Fury beating Wilder threw it off, I guess.
So. Yeah, and you know, I don't know. I think Fury, I don't think anybody's touching Fury right now while he's focused.
How old is he?
He's got to be mid-30s.
And Anthony Joshua is probably no younger, but still, I'm excited. Any heavyweight, you know, headliners like this, like there's so few of them that are worth the attention. Tyson Fury is a great showman. Anthony Joshua, not as much, but he's a good fighter, good specimen and whatnot. It's, you know, good technically.
First team all body.
Definitely.
Just the closest thing, like we talked about Creed earlier, Creed 2. Like Michael B. Jordan's utter, like just over the top jacked in it. Anthony Joshua is that way.
They used to have a full wall, top to bottom, like, I don't know what you call it, poster, but it was the whole wall was just decorated basically, like with Anthony Joshua, hands on hips, topless or shirtless photo at like the Nike store in North Park. Mm. And it was about the closest I'd been as an adult at feeling like I was like back in Abercrombie and Fitch, like getting a little quarter chub from an advert at the mall. Like Anthony Joshua was, you know, getting it right now.
What? No, I didn't. I was looking up, the Marv. Sorry, go.
What were you looking at?
Look at Marv Albert's history.
I thought he said marbles at first.
I did too. What?
Or markets. And I'm like, either one of those I'm going to need to know more about. The other one I know more about.
KJ, essentially KJ said, put this on the run it back segment. KJ got a quarter chub from an Anthony Joshua cutout a la Abercrombie in high school.
Very sick. I'm very at it right sick. Now.
And everybody knows what he's talking about.
You don't hear much. The quarter chub doesn't get much play.
No, but. It's always just the half chub.
Well, sometimes it's QC season. Luck out. And
you know, it's you not QC season.
You don't have to tug it, but you do have to adjust. Otherwise,
yeah, you got to be careful.
Ridge.
Okay. Don't say ridge.
We miss this. Anytime things get released Monday afternoon or Tuesday, it just completely misses our news cycle. Being, you know, one a day podcast in the spring, which I'm not lobbying to change that. It just happens. But we were blessed on the TL last week with Jerry Jones / Post Malone.
Oh, yeah.
With Jaguars / Florida Man. The Falcons did a cartoon of sorts. It looked like Archer. I'm sure other teams did bad things, too. I didn't see
we
them
had
all
the,
trickle
the
up.
Falcons did Game of Thrones a couple years ago.
Uh-huh.
And it was really well done.
I think this is the, like, Olympics for the whoever equivalent to Randy is, like in each of these teams' buildings, like they're just hammering away. I was gonna say beating away, hammering away, trying to put this together like post draft. This is all they do to get this ready to show off like how cool their team is for interactions. And every year, I'm just like, this seems so forced, except for the Cowboys go straight rap music strip club video, basically.
They got Post, they got your boy Posty in there,
yeah. That was a kind of a tight little. I enjoyed it.
Did you see Klein?
Excuse me.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm cool with that.
No, I didn't. Yeah,
was he in it? He was not.
No. He wasn't.
Dak and Zeke were. Little cameo.
As Jerry and Posty were making it rain schedules, I guess, on them.
Yeah.
Is that what that was?
Yeah, it was a little forced. Kind of weird. But still.
The Chiefs did a card pack opening. Again, every team's got a bit for this. I don't like how synchronized that everybody has a bit. And the you NFL does this like schedule release thing. It's like 7 p.m.
Wait,
Tuesday night.
Do the Patriots do this?
Surely they do not. Something because
they're probably forced to.
Yeah, I agree. What do you think about the NFL's approach to releasing schedules this way in the first place? Like, hey, on April, whatever the day is, like schedules drop.
Don't care. Like, if there's these videos, the accompanying videos, that's cool. I'll watch those. I'll watch the Cowboy ones and any other good ones that pop up on the timeline. But I don't need to go break the schedule down.
So you're not going to fly to London with me to watch the Jags and Dolphins?
I would go to that. That'll be fun.
It would be terrible. Nobody's trying to watch Tua and Trevor Lawrence in London.
Dude, pints with the lads?
That would be dope.
Dude, watch Tebow out there running right abroad up the scene.
Let's do it. Fucking hell. Don't remind me of that.
Tim Tebow.
Right.
Oh, we didn't even get to that.
Yeah, it happened during our show last week, thankfully. Also over the weekend, FCS Championship or Division II Championship. Usually, you would know that this is happening because North Dakota State would be in it, and it makes sense and sound familiar. This year, South Dakota State, Jackrabbits, playing the Bearcats.
Bearcats with a K. State.
Yes, with a K, oddly enough. Huntsville?
Yes.
That's where their school is. I think we talked about this recently.
Is a bearcat a real animal?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Yeah,
man.
No, I think...
Is it half bear, half cat?
Dude, that's an agile animal.
Is the bearcat with a K different from the Cincinnati bearcat?
It's hard to say.
They're totally different cats.
A lot of questions. Well, yeah, nobody's going to go back and watch the game. I wouldn't. I watched a little clip on it. South Dakota State's got a running back who put up like 200 yards, 3 touchdowns. Had a really, really hell of a game. They were up, 2, 3, 4 points. They were up, I think, a touchdown. Fourth down, seconds left, Sam Houston State scores last minute. Great game, even with the rain delay. I missed it live because of the rain delay, but it was an entertaining recap that I saw.
Yeah, also, I was probably watching Creed 2.
8-hour saga, can't see anything else.
It's like the Godfather trilogy.
Wanted to give a quick shout-out to former high school teammate Billy Skinner, who's a Sam Houston State grad, new head coach at Arlington Lamar High School.
Well,
which
the Vikings.
Only worth noting, not just because I played with them, but when I was in high school, we had a coach that had been there for 35 years and was there for the next 10 years. They've had one other coach since the inception of that high school in between, maybe two, between Coach Peach, who's, late great Coach Peach, and Billy. So it's a pretty big deal. It's like very him cool. Being the Mike Tomlin of that cool. High school.
Let's get Billy on.
Well, we could. I'm sure
high
we would.
High School Sports Minute.
So yes,
and
to
now,
wrap us up,
Dylan, the story you've been waiting on, Marv Albert retiring after the NBA playoffs this year.
Very cool. Very cool, Marv Albert. I don't have much else. I don't have much else to say.
He's
on
my
it.
Father.
I made my comment earlier, not really knowing the full depth of the story. Like the, he has
who's my father, Marv Albert. I'm Kenny.
That's my Kenny
doing,
Albert.
You're doing Fat Albert?
It's no, Kenny Albert. Kenny Albert sounds like he's underwater perpetually.
Sounded like Fat Albert.
Kenny Albert? While not good on NFL, I think he is a great hockey play-by-play guy.
Whoever was calling Panthers Lightning was exceptional. Sounded a little bit like Mark Folwell. But anyhow.
Congratulations to Marv on a spectacular career.
Yes. Anything else? Any other notes?
I'll just say that.
The note that we've been hinting around here, if you're not familiar with Marv Albert, he's a voice that you would recognize. He'll be calling several playoff games throughout the NBA playoffs.
Very famous and recognizable
voice. Did all the big Jordan games of my childhood.
You will hear his voice is about as much as you would hear like Keith Jackson or Brent Musburger, like John Madden. Like, it's a voice you hear and know. I will just read these two paragraphs directly because I don't need to zhuzh this up, if you will. From the Los Angeles Times in 1997. Albert had originally pled not guilty after being accused by a longtime lover of throwing her on the bed, repeatedly biting her on the neck, and forcing her to perform oral sex in an Arlington hotel room. Shout out to Arlington, Texas.
Agtown. Whoa, this was in Texas?
I believe so.
I didn't know that.
The woman said Albert became enraged because she failed to procure another man and bring him to bed with them. Albert finally agreed to the plea bargain after a second woman, a surprise witness, testified that 3 years ago, Albert had met her in a motel room while wearing white panties and a garter belt. Mm-hmm. He lunged at her and then bit her. She said the woman testified that she escaped his clutches after ripping his toupee off his head.
Okay. That's
end
just
quote.
Unnecessary detail.
Happy trails, Marv Albert.
Well, Marv Albert certainly had a nice second half of his career if he were able to come back.
I was
going
to say, clearly he was never to be heard of again.
He recovered.
Yeah. I mean, he probably thought that was the last time he'd ever put on a headset.
Well, that was during the...
like Tom Brenneman, got outed for...
That was during the Jordan run.
It was. I just remember, you know, what a move by Jordan. You know, I don't have a Marv Albert.
You know, he went back-to-back 96, 97.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You hear about that?
Much like Elton John, not enough people give Jordan credit for his back-to-back championships.
Jordan won numerous championships.
Guys, it's been fun, but from back-to-back to run it back.
It's time for Run It Back, the segment during which we talked about what we already talked about. I'm going to skip the Marv Albert stuff, I think. Anyway, Dave was holding the squad back in Verdansk.
Okay.
You did, Dave.
We're not going to blame
my child, really. But
Super Sage Northcutt did not get the antagonist role in Creed 2. Also, the movie stinks.
It sucks.
The Nelson is attended by people who would typically get stuck in the washing machine.
Okay.
I don't really know what that
means. Doesn't really make a lot of sense.
The crack of the wood bat is the best sound in sports. Yeah, definitely. We're not doing the name.
We're just for a lot of reasons.
Ben Wallace and Horny Jennifer.
Looking at it on fucking
Ben
on
Wallace,
paper, it's uncomfortable.
It's a lot worse.
Ben Wallace and Horny Jennifer were the original Bennifer. People forget. J. Cole has Billen. Bars and a hot little J. Dylan doesn't need to impress Dave or KJ, as they are not his new friends. Ben Wallace, noted meat smoker.
All
Dave
meat
is bullish on the Mavs.
Smoke it, bae.
KJ got a quarter chop from an Anthony Joshua cutout.
That's
and
true.
And a bear cat may or may not be a real animal. And that, folks, is Run It Back.
Thank you, Dylan.
Yeah, that was a fun one.
What's this storm doing?
Let's take a little peek.
Past.
Oh, slow down, still raining.
That? That storm was us just doing the pod.
Oh.
Sun trying to fight through a little bit.
Ooh, that's not good, man. That little heating, a little convection.
A little sun chow.
Gives a little energy to these storms that might come in later.
Uh-oh. Dogs will love
hate
it.
To see
watch
it.
Out. No, hey, we needed it. Guys, thank you so much. We will see you next Monday with probably heavy NBA.
Bye, bye.
I want my chips with the dip. That's all I know. I don't want my chips playing. I want my chips with the dip. So bring them dips.